This is my favorite way of shooting with continuous light. Now, continuous light basically means that you have a light and it's on all the time. It's not a flash where the actual power that's affecting your exposure is coming out all at once and a burst. Continuous light is almost like a baby step to shooting with off-camera flash because you get used to what it's like to have a light coming in, an exterior light, and having to mesh the ambient light in the room with it or knock it out. Now, obviously, or maybe not so obvious, a flash is much more powerful, so you can completely knock out, darken, negate the natural light or the ambient light in your shot. With continuous light, you probably don't have that, but it's still a really great way to start using some kind of off-camera light source. The other way it's a nice baby step is because when you have a continuous light, you can see what it's doing. You can see how it's shaping the face. You can see, you know, where the light direction is, where the shadows are, where the light may or may not be hitting in the wrong spots. Now, if you're going to use continuous light, I do suggest you find a light like the Westcott Solix Bicolor lights that have color temperature dials on it. So you can have the light go really warm or have it go really cold. Now, when I'm shooting Alina in this case, who just happens to be right behind me here. Can you hear me? No. Now, in shooting this shot of Alina, I decided to really warm up the backlight so we had that nice kind of golden haze. But just warming up one light wasn't enough of a difference between the light that was on her face and the light that was behind her. So I did the exact opposite to the light that was affecting her face and I cooled it down a whole bunch. Now you can see that I'm directing and posing Alina here, but we didn't have good audio, so sorry you can't hear that. If you want some inspiration on posing, then make sure you download my free posing guide in the link below. Now you might be thinking that these Solix lights are small and therefore a hard light source, and you'd be right. So I had to manipulate that somehow. What I did is I have two sets of foldable V-flats from V-flat World. One of them is behind her, strategically positioned so that the light behind her can come over the top of the background, hit her, but not so much. The background almost acts as like a block. And I got this technique, by the way, from Sue Bryce. I saw her do it once by having the backdrop lowered, your client seated, and natural window light coming from behind. Well, I didn't have natural window light in the studio, so I had the continuous light. So V-flat behind her, my client sitting down, light coming from behind, and now to have a soft light on her face, which we really want, we need the light source to be bigger. So I took my other V-flat and pointed the Solix light into it. So now my light source is this big V-flat. It produced a beautifully soft light on Alina and got exactly what I was looking for. It almost looks like these shots could be natural light and maybe I'm using a window or two, but instead I have a lot of control. So step by step, how to get this shot. You need two different continuous lights. I have the Westcott Bicolor Solix lights. You want one of those lights behind your subject, pointed towards your subject and towards the camera as warm as it can go. And then another light, lighting the front of your subject as cool as it can go. So as you raise your white balance and the photo gets warmer so that the skin tone looks appealing, the light in the back is gonna get even warmer. This is just a really fun, easy way to use continuous lights and maybe as a baby step for off-camera flash. Hit like, subscribe, and leave me a comment and tell me how you use continuous lights for your photography. Do you think they're easy to use? Do you think they're difficult? Let me know what you think.